South Korea for my first World Championship. I was very, very happy to go on with the sport and going to another level. Preparing for London Olympics, me plus my coach, we were working very hard so that our dreams come true. Yeah. Because our dream was to reach the finals. As long as we reach to the finals, yeah, anything can happen there. Some few weeks to the departure for the London Olympics, that's the time when I received a call from my international manager telling me my blood sample, they're having some problem, technical problem, and you can't go for the competition. My local officials from my federation told me that you have to stay home, not moving. Yeah. And if anyone asks you, tell them that you have an injury whereby I was a person who is injury free. However, you know, I wasn't sick. One official from the IAAF, he tried to reach me, and after some few weeks, I think, they had me travel to go to Nice for body checkup, like measuring my whole body and putting me into a machine, yeah? Just like scanning me, the whole body, and getting more other blood samples from me. Yeah, it was something which was really confused. Like as if there were people who are not talking straight to you, telling you that this and this like this, yeah? But just telling you, do this, do this. Do this, yeah. Went to a doctor with an executive from the federation because she was with me, escorting me and going to the hospital. They took me to the operation room and they said that they are gonna use the injection thing. Whereby waking up, finding myself I'm having cuts. I say, whoa, they've done something which we didn't agree on. Yeah. And really, I was so scared. The people who were there with me, taking me to the hospital, wanted me to do such. After the operation, no one came back to me to see what really. Oh, no one came in to do a follow-up. No one explained to me what's really the truth. It was something which was just making me to go in that trap. I call it trap because it was a trap. Yeah. It took me 7 years without nothing. As in, they didn't give me straight information that after the surgery, you have to go for hormone therapy throughout the whole of your life, yeah? Really, that was so hard on me. For 7 years, no one is coming to look for you. For 7 years, no one is minding to know where you are, yeah? It was really a strange life.
As soon as you pass here, you start slowing down the pace. Don't sort of focus on the stride length.
Okay.
Keep the body moving, you know what I mean? That you feel that the body is moving at the same pace.
Yeah.
Why are they focusing too much to people of the southern continent? Yeah. That shows that they're discriminating and racism in the sport, because all of us, we are human beings and we are females. Yeah. What I can say, let them stop taking people's or playing on people's bodies. Yeah, making people to be guinea pigs and doing their research on human beings. and violating human rights. Yeah. My dream at first was taken away from me, but with God I trust that it will come back to me. And now I came back for training and I'm already in the process. I'm working for it again. I have to fight for my dream. I have to fight for it. That's my future now. I'm focusing on my dream, which was taken away from the IWF regulations.